I don't know much about fashion, but I know what I like. A see-through skirt, a customised inhaler, and saying a shoe when I mean shoes. I think we're all on the same page, right? But not so sure about the high prices, spindly supermodels and planetary cost? Don't worry. Here at Only Connect, we're celebrating only the best of the fashion world. We've assembled all our most fashion-conscious quizzes from across our 18 series, then made up the numbers with a few more, to create a special night that's on trend, yet affordable and conscientious, celebrating fashion through the medium of quiz. The medium of quiz? What's wrong with the extra large of quiz? Nothing, that's what. So let's say an extra large hello again to our returning heroes on my right. Oscar Powell, a teacher of English as a foreign language who can sing the Pilgrim's Chorus from Tannhäuser while doing a headstand. Lewis Barn, a licensing lawyer who's the 12th great-grandson of James V of Scotland. And their captain, Jack Bennett, a quality assurance specialist who's the world record holder in custard pie throwing. United by a taste for tailoring, they are the Dandies. Welcome back, Jack. We last saw you in 2017.
We did.
Are you still quizzing together as a team?
We have not been in the same room together since our last match of Only Connect, but it's so good to be back.
Absolutely.
Am I imagining it, or has your taste in clothes become a little more restrained since we saw you last?
Well, fashion changes over time, doesn't it? So we've dropped the ties and done a few more buttons, and yeah.
Not that many more buttons.
Hopefully our quiz knowledge is just as good as it was before.
Yeah. I, for one, am hugely in favour. Thank you for coming back. This time you are facing, on my left, Alan Peters, a jewellery maker who enjoys visiting old cemeteries. Sophie Cook, a former crime intelligence analyst turned milliner. And their captain, the breakout star of Only Connect 2022, adored by viewers and the internet alike, the phenomenal Lizzie Biscuits. All sharing a passion for fashion, they are the Peacocks. Welcome back, Lizzie. We never went to Paris together.
Don't I've told everybody we did.
Oh, well, I loved our time in Paris together. Now, let me ask you, you've brought along a new team member. Your former quizzer, Paul, has been made a judge and decided it's day class A to be seen in this low-rent company. So who of your acquaintances have you decided is not too posh to come?
Hi.
Hello, Sophie.
Hello,
tell me a bit
Victoria.
About yourself.
I'm a milliner. I make hats for ladies for special occasions.
And have you ever done a quiz before?
A pub quiz?
That'll do.
Not a telly quiz.
Thank you so much for coming to join us. It is absolutely lovely to see you all again. Peacocks, you won the toss. You'll be going first. Please choose a voguish hieroglyph.
The Horned Viper, please.
That will kick off this special with pictures. What do these pictures have in common? Okay. Here's the first.
He's a pianist. Mm-hmm. Next, please. Oh, sport.
Cricket.
A cricketer. Should we just go next? Next, please. Right.
Eye closure?
So, jeans, maybe? Should we get the next?
Get the next.
Yeah.
One.
Next, please.
Oh,
that's Glenda.
Sure.
So they're types of trousers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Should we go for that? Types of trouser.
I will take it, particularly because you used the singular. Talk me through the clues, please.
Claire short.
Short, exactly.
Wyclef Jean.
Jean or Jean.
A cricketer.
His surname is Pant, like the American trouser.
And a pianist.
I think the first one's Philip Glass, isn't
it? It's Philip Glass. Now, I had hoped to hear generally items of clothing, but this is the fashion special. Who's to say you can't wear a glass trouser? Not me.
Oh, Iggy Pop. And yeah, see-through trousers.
There you go.
This is why we brought
That's
her.
That's a sight you can't unsee.
Very nice. What about you, Alan? Would you wear glass trousers, do you think?
Yeah.
Who wouldn't? Who wouldn't? You are correct for 1 point. Dandies, what would you like?
Twisted flax, please.
Twisted flax. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
Some courageous.
There's also Bar Vest in the first one.
Oh, yeah. That's good. Which one's the first one?
The first word contains two examples of the second word.
So come on! 5 points! You haven't been in a room together since you played this quiz in 2017. Why not? You could have been garnering trophies nationwide. Let's bring up all the clues. The second one was actually a tribute to your former appearance. Talk us through it, please.
The first word contains two words, but an example of the second, so bra, vest, and obviously underwear. Mm-hmm.
Victor and Ian for the second one, men's names.
That's it.
Key and note for different types of musical terms.
Head and butt for body parts. Very well done. Was it a Victorian look you were sporting back in Series 13?
I think it was just whatever we had close to hand in the wardrobe, wasn't it?
I mean, I have a memory of sort of cravats and velvet jackets.
I definitely wore a velvet jacket I got on either the 16th or 17th of July 2016 in Whitby for £20, on which I've since spilt black printer ink, but still wear regularly because it carries bigger books than any of my other jackets.
That is a magnificent, detailed anecdote of the kind I like. Congratulations. 5 points to you. Well, Peacocks, you've got some work to do. Which hieroglyph will you be working on?
The Eye of Horus, please.
The Eye of Horus. What is the connection between these clues? Here's the first.
Like their names. So they're obviously names of people, surnames, or like Wang, Alexander Wang or Vera Wang. Next, please. Are these? Right, well, that's what Trump said, isn't it?
Next one.
Next, please. It's Barbara Hall. Can they, they're protest T-shirts, I think. She met, but Barbara Hall. Next, please. So I think they're slogans on fashion garments, yeah?
Okay.
Yep. Slogans worn by fashion design or fashion garments used as protest.
They are protest slogans on clothes. What can you tell me about any of the clues?
58% don't want Pershing was Barbara Hall Kinnicky.
It was Catherine Hamnett.
Oh, but... I'm sorry, fashion gods. I'm going to get cancelled on Twitter
and
now.
And who was Catherine Hamnett meeting at that time?
Was it Margaret Thatcher?
Thatcher in 1984. It was a protest against nuclear weapons.
I'm assuming Build the Wall is a Trump reference.
Yes, it's the singer Joy Villa, a Trump supporter, and she went along with a Make America Great Again handbag, and that was actually at the Grammys, and a wall-patterned dress to signal her support for building a wall between America and Mexico. And what about that first clue?
I'm not sure.
Eight film directors. I don't think we know where that's actually from, though, do we?
They are eight film directors, and they are women film directors, and Natalie Portman went to the Oscars in 2020 with a cape emblazoned with their names as a sign of protest that women weren't being nominated for the Best Director Oscar. And that last clue, tax the rich, that's the politician, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, wore it to the Met Gala. It was a white dress that said tax the rich. And it was controversial because, obviously, it was full of rich people. But what's the point of wearing it somewhere else? That's the brave thing, isn't it? She's taken it to the interface. Back to you, Dandies, for a choice.
Lion, please.
Lion. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
That looks like a scientific name. It's a dinosaur of some sort. I bet it's a sauropod. I don't know. The second bit means it vaguely is related to China. I don't know.
Next, please.
India.
Where is Lotharingia?
The first.
Is this another word?
Germany, isn't
it? I think we should
remember. Oh, it's things that have given a name to clothing.
Could be.
Next, please. Oh, are they the ones that wear the neck?
Yes, so how does that relate to the other two?
Neck.
Do give the name to headwear or what?
Do you want four for doing that?
Next, please.
Okay. 2 seconds.
Long necks.
Yeah, long necks or necks.
They have long necks. What can you tell me about any of these clues?
I don't actually know, but that scientific name at the start is giving me in sauropod vibes, and sauropods generally have long necks.
It's a dinosaur. It was discovered in China in 1987, and they reckon it had a neck that was over 15 metres long. So that
sounds like a sauropod.
You know, longer than a double-decker bus. So if that's right, it would be the longest neck of any creature that we know about so far.
Okay. I think the Kayan Lawi women are the women who wear the sort of rings around their neck to help elongation.
That's right, and it pushes down the collarbone because there in northern Thailand, their fashion would be to have a very long neck, bejewelled. And Reginald I of Lotharingia, French nobleman.
Known as the long neck.
Reginald long neck, exactly so. Peacocks, what would you like next?
Two reeds, please.
Two reeds. What connects these clues? Here's the first.
Next, please.
Right. Cambridge
grapefruit. The Cambridge grapefruit. Should we go next?
Yeah.
Next, please.
Oh.
Right. Like, is it Cambridge? You get Cambridge blue. Could it be colour? Cambridge dictionary.
Blue grapefruit.
Oh,
blue grapefruit.
Should we just get next? Next, please. Diets. Diets.
They are all diets. Fad diets, some might say.
Not a fan of diets. That's why it took so long.
What do these diets involve?
Not eating cake, I imagine. Atkins is no carbs.
No carbs.
The Paleolithic is that you would eat like a caveman. I think
yes, and that's maybe not as unhealthy as some diets, because I suppose you're not eating modern processed food. Though I'm always very suspicious of any ethos which is, you know, we should do things like cavemen did. It always ends up back in a place where men are saying they ought to be able to sleep around because that's natural. And the Cambridge diet, that's a sort of milkshakes, which is the idea of replacing your normal food with shakes.
Oh, OK. I didn't know that had a name.
Original Slim Fast.
Yes. Of course, other horrible-tasting shakes are available. Dandies, one question remains. The water, speaking of diets, it's a glug of water for you. The music question, of course, what do these clues have in common? Here's the first. Screams
for us. Do we know this? So next, please.
Some Scottish folk song. I should have known. No, I'll say next, please. Just what the truth is. I can't say anymore.
We've got time if you think you can put this in. I'll take the last one just now. Next, please. Make me feel real loose, like a long-necked goose, or like a girl. Oh, baby, that's the one I like. What's that, honey? Make one of
2 seconds.
Give the name to dancers.
They do not all give their name to dancers. Peacocks, you want to go for a bonus point?
Types of fabric?
It is fabrics. What did we hear?
Knights in White Satin.
Mm-hmm.
And some other songs.
Stop it! The Big Bopper, Chantilly Lace.
Chantilly Lace. Yeah.
And the first one, White Leather by Wolf Alice. The second one, Lewis.
I'm sorry.
You're Scottish
royalty. I'm going to get roasted online for this.
It was Ali's Tartan Army, which was Scotland's song for the 1978 World Cup.
Of course it was. Oh. It's a good job this isn't going to be on TV, right?
It's a good job it's not going to be on TV. And, you know, that's a bit of a curveball, because not everybody knows that tartan is a fabric. People think that it's a pattern. Do you have a family tartan?
I don't actually know, but I used to work in a Highlandwear Outfitters for about 5 years. So, yeah, really should have got that one. That's
you should have got that one. So, bonus point to you, Peacocks. And that means at the end of round one, the Peacocks have 4 points, the Dandies have 6. Round two is the sequences round, or perhaps I should say the sequences round. And you'll be going first again. Peacocks, what would you like?
Water, please.
Water. These are going to be picture clues. What would you expect to see in the fourth picture? Here's the first.
OK, that's Sandra Oh.
Yeah.
Next, please. That's Tempora. Sandra Oh. Is it temp or is it something else? We can't get the next one.
1 second. Oh, you've run out of time, so I'm going to throw it over for a possible bonus to the Dandies.
A moray eel?
A moray eel?
Or several moray eels.
Or several moray eels. And why?
Well, we think the phrase is... It's Sandra Oh is the person in both clues 1 and 3, and we're spelling out in pictures the phrase O tempora, O mores.
This is one of my favourite questions of all time. O tempora, O mores, which is, of course, the Cicero phrase about time and fashion, you know, the times, the customs. And we've spelt that out in words that don't really sound like it at all.
Particularly scary, because they essentially have a second set of jaws lodged in the back of their mouths, which they can extend, essentially like a xenomorph from Alien, and drag in prey that they should not really be able to eat.
I mean, good moray knowledge. I mean, you've really well done, because you've done the word puzzle, the Latin, and the eel background. Very impressive. So you get the bonus point and you may choose a question. What would you like?
I will never get another chance to say this again. So can we have the twisted flax, please, Victoria?
Yes, you can. You can untwist this flax. What will come forth of the sequence? Here's the first.
Vermilion is a shade of red.
Yes, it's a part of...
Well, is it country? It's countries, isn't it? Because it's Romania. And it's the shade, because the chat flap.
We need to...
We need to take another one. Next, please.
right.
So red amber. Oh, is it? Okay, so it's red orange. Oh, so it's a mix of colours. So red, a mix of red, yeah, orange, vermilion. Orange. So yellow, it's going to be yellow, green, then green, blue. So it's going to be GB. What's a mixture of green and blue?
Turquoise.
GB, turquoise, or teal. Yeah, okay.
GB, turquoise.
Is an acceptable answer. Very well done. Let's bring up all the clues. Mm. Lewis, I think you spotted this. What's the sequence?
Yes, so take the first clue, for example. The RO stands for red-orange, and if you combine those, you get vermilion. We then move along one extra colour to orange-yellow to get amber, and so on until you end up with something like teal or turquoise for green and blue.
Exactly so. Just because it's a special, you're not safe from the old rainbow sequence. We're going through the colours of the rainbow and you call them tertiary colours. If you mix a primary colour with a secondary colour, you get a tertiary colour. So any combination of green and blue, turquoise, teal, anything like that. Well done. Back to you. Peacocks for a choice. What would you like?
The horned viper, please.
What will be the fourth clue in this sequence? Here's the first.
Oh, sport. Seeking the Rugby World Cup. Next, please. Right. So this is something people... Oh,
is it? I don't know.
It's something that people have done, so it's probably going to be 22. Mm. So is it United Dolly Parton put money into coronavirus? So should we just get next,
get
the
next one?
Next one? Oh, the Google searches. Google, yeah?
Okay. Yeah.
Top Google searches 2022.
Well, you can have the points for top Google search of 2022. These are Google search trends in the UK. Do you want to have a go at what was the most Googled thing in 2022?
Oh, didn't the English women's football team win the World Cup?
That wasn't the most looked up thing, but OK, it was Wordle.
Oh, right.
That was the thing. According to Google Trends, the most looked up thing in 2022 was Wordle. But you get the points because you solved the puzzle. Very well done. Dandies, what would you like?
Lion, please.
Lion. OK, what would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Yeah, could be.
Next, please.
It's
M-I-D-I.
So was that
Smoosh?
Is M-E-D a singing prayer?
Is it just like repeated, like MIDI?
OK.
Is it singing? Next, please.
The
definitions that repeated.
Well, hold on, I need to know what will come forth. Yeah.
French midnight.
I'm tempted to take that. I was generous with your opponents. Why would that be?
Well, we've taken the second clue and just changed it about a bit.
Well, that's very interesting. I'm going to let you have it. You haven't solved the puzzle, but you've got the right answer. So, singing priest is the singer Maxi Priest. So, Maxi. French midday is MIDI. Maxi, MIDI. Mm-hmm. A jerk response, knee. It's dress lengths going down, and it's, well, rather going up. Maxi, MIDI, knee, and then we want mini. Mm. But I assume, what with your Scottish accent, when you say minuit, the French midnight, you pronounce it mini.
Absolutely.
It's basically the same word.
Oh,
I mean, isn't it? A minuit skirt? We've all worn one.
There's no accent prejudice on the show at all.
There's absolutely none. What would a French woman say when she's bought a new miniskirt? I've just bought a lovely new minuit skirt. I think so.
We would have said a very small toy car, as in micro.
That would be next, wouldn't it? Because it's shorter than mini.
Getting shorter, yeah.
Have you ever worn a micro skirt?
No.
I was speaking to Alan.
It's like a Tyrannosaurus.
Yeah. You have, yeah. I mean, just on a hot day, do you know what I mean? It's just comfy, isn't it? Yeah. So well done for getting that point in a roundabout sort of way. Peacocks, what would you like?
The Eye of Horus, please.
Eye of Horus. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Next, please. Right, OK. Oh, that's probably a song.
Be there.
Be there. Never Square.
Be there.
I feel like it's a song.
OK.
Never Square. Yeah. Next, please. An advert jingle? Be there, Never Square, by the best.
Come on. With this slogan,
what's never square? Something that's round. Yeah, what's like a round? Be there, never square.
1 second. No, I'm afraid you've let the time run out. Dandies, do you know?
He's the dedicated follower of fashion.
Dedicated follower of fashion. I think we know what this is. We might be able to play you a blast of it. Can we play them a blast of it? It will make or break him, so he's got to buy the best, 'cause he's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, yes, yes, very well done. So another bonus for you, Dandies, and a question for yourselves. It'll be the two reads. What would come forth in this sequence? Here's the first.
Right, it is... I take the next one because I don't know if it's going backwards or forwards, but it's Oscar wins for the best costume.
Right,
so take the next one.
Next, please.
Right, buzz in. I know what I think it is. For Black Panther Wakanda Forever 2022...
I mean, phenomenal. That is absolutely the answer. The 2022 film Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. Presumably you know what would have been clue three.
Yes, it's what? Oh, goodness me. That is not good. I do know this.
This is actually the famous British designer Jenny Bevan won for Cruella.
Yes, that was right.
And then Black Panther in 2023 for 2022. Do you know who actually picked up the award?
Ruth Carter.
It was Ruth E. Carter. Very well done. That means at the end of round two, the Peacocks have 6 points, the Dandies have 16. Time now for the fashionable vicissitudes of the connecting wall. And it'll be up to you to throw yourselves on the first wall, Dandies. What would you like, lion or water?
Water, please.
Water. You have 2.5 minutes to solve the water wall, starting now.
Here, right, here's the old skinhead crop. Crew cut. Flat top. Skinhead and crop.
Oh, hard sand, so hard sand. No, well, it's just fizzy.
It's fizzy stop. No, fizzy.
Tonic. Oh, excellent. It's just Gangnam Style.
Yeah.
Do we have any more styles? What is that? Is that a song work? Mr. Bombastic?
Synonyms, like this skinhead, crew cut, close shave. But Gangnam would be.
Yeah, we can try that.
Crop. Okay, maybe.
Yeah, let's try flat top with those. Okay. In fact, if those are the five, let's just cycle those. So leave out close shave this time, we'll try those. If we've got close shave.
Yeah, leave that. So leave that.
Maybe bandana, but.
Yeah, we'll put bandana in, so. Close shave then.
Excellent. Now, so these are parts of songs, so there's Gangnam Style. Is that from Mr. Bombastic? Remember, let's just not take the fourth one just now. I think putting on the Ritz or whatever that is and Hit 'Em Up are all songs. So what would connect Crew Cut, Clandestine and... they start with, like, gangs. Crew,
oh, yeah, crew.
Gang, well, Nam, band and clan. And now what connects these songs?
It's bracketed parts, isn't it? It's putting on the...
Oh, excellent. Yeah. So let's do...
30 seconds. You solved the wall. Very well done. Tell me about the connections, fizz, tonic and so on.
Fizzy.
Fizzy drinks.
Takes off water. Yeah.
Well, it can be, but various fizzy drinks. Yeah. And the next group, crop, skinhead and so on.
Close haircuts.
Yeah, short, yeah.
Or short hairstyles. Yeah. And the next group, bandana, clandestine and so on.
They all start with gangs, so you've got like band, clan, gang, crew.
Exactly so, little mobs at the beginning. And the last group, my definition of a bombastic jazz and so on.
Bracketed song titles, putting on the Ritz.
That's not it. I thought you were going to get it because you spotted the red herring, Gangnam. Mm. They all finish in style.
Oh, okay.
But you solved the wall and gave me 3 connections. That's a total of 7 points. Let's bring in the Peacocks now, give them the lion wall and see how they get on. Welcome back, Peacocks. You've got 2.5 minutes to solve this wall, starting now.
OK, werewolf. So cut collar there, think rinse there, things you do to hair. Mm-hmm. So should we try that?
Yeah.
Okay, so there's half-hearted. Heart is a half-mast, half-life. Is there another half, half-cut? Can you see
half
any other halves?
Half-turn.
Right, okay, so that's one. So werewolf, that's quite specific. What is this, some songs or something?
Werewolf.
State of mind, is there a mind thing?
The independence, state of independence.
Is there anything? Let's try with the hair things. Well, and what's balayage? Okay, let's try. Okay, I'm gonna go through these.
Yeah.
Okay. So look at the start of, is there a word one? Blinded by your charm.
Carl, state of decay, state of independence. Is there a fall from grace? Amazing grace, fall from grace. Blinded by your grace, state of grace. So grace.
Oh, that's your three lives, and the war has frozen. But you found two groups. Tell me about the connections. The first group, hearted.
Half.
You can put half of all of them, half-hearted, half-term, and so on. And the next group, colour balayage.
Things you do to hair.
Things you do to hair. And you can still get points for the connections in the groups you didn't find. So let's resolve the wall. State of, blinded by your, and so on.
Grace.
You can put grace after all of them to make songs. And the last group, amazing, wash, and so on.
The start of the word, so am, was, are, and were.
Yes, well spotted, the verb thing. To be yeah, at to the be. Beginning. Yep. So you found two groups, you gave you all the connections. That is a total of 6 points. Let's have a look at the scores going into the final round. The Peacocks have 12 points, the Dandies have 23. But now for the missing vowels round. Fingers on the buzzers, teams. The first group are all famous people and their hats. Peacocks?
Charlie Chaplin in bowler hat.
That's right. Dandies?
Fred Astaire and top hat.
Yes, it is. Well, this one's ridiculous, well, I'll tell you. It's Isambard Kingdom Brunel and stovepipe hat. Next clue. Dandies?
Al Capone and fedora.
Well done. Next category, a song title with a shop in it. Peacocks?
Midnight at the Oasis.
Well done. Dandies?
Jigsaw puzzle.
Yes, it is. Dandies?
If you tolerate this, your children will be next.
Very well done. Dandies?
These boots are made for walking.
Correct. Next category, celebrity fragrances. Peacocks?
White Diamonds by Elizabeth Taylor.
Well done. Peacocks?
Pink Friday by Nicki Minaj.
Well done. Dandies.
Antonio by Antonio Banderas.
Phenomenal. That's so hard. It's the sweet release of the final bell. But that's the end of the quiz. And looking at the final scores after some delightful return quizzing, Peacocks, you finish on an excellent 16 points. Dandies with, you know, series winning 29 points.
Wow.
Very well done. Very well quizzed, all of you. Thank you so much for coming back. I mean, you've all still got it in fashion and quizzing terms. It's been a pleasure to see you all. And thank you very much for watching. Only Connect, the quiz that's trickier than trying to work out if double denim is in or out this season. I'll give you a clue. It's never wrong. Goodbye.